think something came. Let me look out here. Whoa. I'm hoping this is what I think it is. It's a pretty big box. That's a very big box. So we'll go check it out and see what it is.
This is the biggest box I've gotten from Amazon, probably ever. A very big box. I have a feeling what I'm hoping it is my Kmise baritone ukulele. I never had intention of getting a baritone, but I've seen quite a few on the Facebook ukulele group. And recently I've seen a couple of the Kmise baritone ukuleles, and they had a really good sale actually recently, and I just couldn't contain myself, so I ordered it. It's a really big box. I'm very happy that they put the outer box on this one. One of the Kmise ukuleles I got came without an outer box. It just had the box the actual ukuleles in, and it had a little bit of damage. So having this outer box is a great idea. I'm very hopeful about this. Okay. Now this is a little more normal size. Let's take off the cover. Set it aside. And here we go. Strap, which I think is a really good idea for a baritone. Because they're a little bigger than your average size ukulele. So I like having a strap. And it also has some picks. I don't use picks too much for ukuleles. I use them for my guitar, so that's good, but I'll keep a couple in the gig bag. So that's good. And it's always nice to have an extra set of strings here. The one thing I'll say that I don't like about the Kmise ukuleles is the strings all come like this. They're just all twisted together. They're not labeled at all. I can figure it out, but you know, being lazy, I'd rather have them come with a little label saying, here's the E, the low E, the D, the G, etc., etc. And here is the case. Pretty standard type case. I like it has the backpack double strap, so you can wear it like a backpack. And pretty good size accessory bag on the side. So this will hold, you know, whatever you want to put in there, extra strings and things like that. So that's good. It might even be big enough to put my little beetle book in. I'm not sure. In fact, I'm going to go check. And I like that. And I think it will. Let's see. Open this up. Yep. It fits right inside there. So when I carry this on the road with me, I can bring that beetle book and have it with me. Case is pretty standard. It has a handle. And then the back straps. Someone said it doesn't go all the way over. Yeah, it doesn't, it kind of ends halfway on the bottom. I don't think that's a big deal, but I know somebody was complaining about that. Okay, yeah, it would be nice if they had it go over to there so you could actually open the top of it. This way you have to kind of hold it open, peek it open. But it's nice having a gig bag. You're bringing it out of the house just to have something to kind of keep it from getting scratched up. It's not a hard case. I don't have any, the only thing I have a hard case for is my 12-string Ovation guitar. So I like having a case, it's nice. So here it is. It's, and it has a little Allen wrench. This is for the, I don't remember the name of it, that little bar that's in the neck to adjust the action. So that's nice having that. I don't think you have to adjust it very much, but I guess if you needed to, you could. Okay. Let's see. Wow. Nice. And that's what the headstock looks like. Let's see. And the strings are covered with some kind of paper, so we'll take that off and check it out. And I like the fact it has the strap buttons on, one on the bottom and then one underneath the neck here, so you can put that on. Kind of a semi-gloss, matte finish. It's a nice finish, nice and smooth. Let's see what the neck's like. Not bad. The frets, you can feel them. They're not totally smooth, but they're not bad. I'll probably end up smoothing those down just a little bit. Sealed tuners, clear. And this is what it looks like. Close up of the bridge and the saddle. And the neck. Okay, and it has the fret markers on, you can go around. The fret markers on 5, 7, 10, and 12, which is pretty standard. The little ones have one, some of them have it on 3 also. And then it has the buttons on the side, which is nice. I don't know how often I use that, but I think it's nice to have, so you don't have to, if you're gonna look, you don't have to go like this. You just look down on it. So I'm sure it's out of tune. Yeah, very much out of tune. So I'm gonna tune it up and then I'll do a little strumming so you can hear what it sounds like. Something's rattling in there. I think there's something inside there. I'll get back to you. It took me a while to figure out what that rattling noise was. I thought, is something loose inside? But it's the little silica gel they put in there, I guess, to keep it from getting too moist or something. I've never seen one of these for ukulele, but that's what it was. So now, no noise. Okay, I'm gonna give it a few days to settle in because the strings, when they're new, they go out of tune real quick. But I wanna just mention a couple of things about this that I like. Again, it's a baritone from Kmise. One thing I like, it's kinda cool. If you just play it like this, it's basically the highest four strings on a guitar, DGBE. So you can play this and you have kind of a nice guitar sound without the top two strings. So I like that. That's kind of a cool thing. That's nice. Another thing that's pretty cool is if you have a capo, you can put it on the 5th fret, and as I'm sure those of you familiar with ukulele know, 5th fret of a guitar, it's a ukulele. It's actually a low G ukulele, because this is a standard guitar string. So basically on the 5th fret, you're just playing a regular ukulele, and I have a low G tenor, so I don't know why I'd want to do that, but it's kind of cool. So this is ukulele position here, like a soprano or concert or tenor. But this baritone, I purposely ordered this one because it was tuned DGBE. I didn't want another GCEA, which would be just another ukulele, but I wanted the alternate tuning like the guitar. So it's pretty cool. And the other thing is, right now it's like a standard ukulele. If I capo it up more, I can raise the tone for my voice. But the thing that's cool on this if I want to lower the tone, lower the key just a little bit for my voice, I can't really do it on a standard ukulele because you can only capo it up higher. But on this, I can move it down one, two, or three, like that, and then you got... Then you're changing the key, and you can figure out the key by just... Each fret is a one half step. It take me a while to get used to playing it. I've never played a baritone or a four-string guitar, basically, so I'm looking forward to it. And after I get it all settled in and get used to it, I'll probably throw a few demos up. But overall, the price was just phenomenal. It came with this and the strap buttons on it, extra set of strings, and really nice. I like everything about it. The frets are a little bit sharp, but those are easy to smooth down, and I can do that. But other than that, everything looks good on it. Again, this is the Kmise KMU-30B Baritone, and I think they have a really good sale going on right now if you're interested, but something new to my collection. So now I got soprano, I got concert, tenor, and finally I have a baritone. Oh, and I have a banjo-lele too, so I'm all set, whatever kind of music I want to play. Okay, bye-bye. One last thing that I think is pretty cool about the baritone. If you're used to playing ukulele as standard, soprano, tenor, or concert, and you have all these chord shapes that you know, something cool about this is you can, if you have a song that you know in the key of, let's say G, for example, and it's just too high, you can't sing it, and you want to sing it a little lower, instead of transposing the key, you can grab this and it'll be five half steps lower because this is tuned like a guitar. A ukulele's tuned on the fifth fret. It's like that. So, for example, if I'm playing a song in the key of G, I can use my same chord shapes that I use on the ukulele, but the key of G becomes the key of D. And one way to think of that is for a baritone that's tuned like a guitar. D, G, B, E. Because D, this string's the D string. On a ukulele, it's tuned as G, that's G. So you go down G, G flat, F, E, E flat, and D. So right here, I'm playing the chord shape for the key of, or for the for G, but on the baritone, this is actually D. So a song that I know the chord shapes for in the key of D becomes the key of A. One in the key of A becomes the key of E, which is a kind of a hard chord to play on a standard ukulele. Well, for the baritone, you just play A. That's actually E. Just play A. So another little handy feature about having it. So I like having this hanging on the wall with my other ukuleles. It'll come in handy, and that's kind of a fun little trick. And as I mentioned before, you just put a capo right there and you're playing a regular ukulele. Okay.